the update of Blender to version 5.0 is adding a lot of game-changing features to the compositor, including node group menus, new color spaces, new very powerful nodes, and of course the integration of the compositor into Blender's video editor. I've made sure to make use of these new additions and expanded my free compositing pack MPComp to now include over 100 unique effects, which are a great addition to the new compositing node groups that Blender now natively ships with. In case you're wondering how it's possible that the pack is free, I offer the pack as donationware, which means you can either just download the pack for free or pay any amount you think is justified. And now, for the first time ever, I added a new way of supporting the project, which I will get back to later in this video. So let's go over some of the new effects, how Blender 5.0 opened up new possibilities, and how MPComp works using the new VSE compositor. And trust me, there are a lot of game-changing features in this update. I received a lot of positive comments regarding the complex filter category of MPComp, which includes effects for VHS, NTSC, and CRT emulation. So I expanded this category with two new effects, including MP_corruption, which creates visual glitches you know from corrupted buffers and faulty displays. It's really useful to add unpredictable glitches to your footage, either for jump cuts, impacts, or maybe as some sort of horror element. Then there also is the new MP_ASCII effect, which actually has been requested by a user a few months ago. Basically, return your image into a set of symbols, numbers, and characters. There are a few integrated sets you can choose from, like math operators, numbers, letters, or a mix of all of them. And in case you don't like any of them, you can hook up a custom bitmap to be used by the effect. This means you can adjust the effect to use any font and symbols you like. You just need to create a 4x4 grid of the symbols and make sure that the bitmap is in a square aspect ratio. To create such a grid, you can just use this tool in your browser called Font to Bitmap. You can choose a font by either using a service like Google Font and paste the link into the tool, or upload locally installed fonts yourself. Then enter up to 16 symbols and set the grid up to show 4 symbols per row. The effect will map the symbols to the brightness of the input image. The darkest area of the image will use the symbol in the bottom left corner of the grid, and the brightest area will use the symbol in the top right corner. So make sure to type in the symbols in the order you want them to display accordingly. As soon as you're done setting everything up, you can just download the grid as a PNG, drag it into the compositor, set the effect to use a custom bitmap, and then connect your grid. Just make sure to set the position of the compositor to full instead of auto when working with the real-time compositor. For some reason, it affects the amount of levels for the brightness map I've created. You can also customize the color palette of the effect to either consist out of two colors, use the colors of the input image, or to use a random color for each symbol. And you can also add a slight animation to the effect by adding a bit of randomness to the mapping of the symbols. Now that we covered the new complex effects, let's get to the new effects that add essentials of other compositing and video editing software to Blender. This includes MP_mirror, which lets you create symmetrical effects in a very intuitive way. You can just easily adjust the angle of the mirror and also both offset the mirror and the input image individually to create all sorts of different symmetry effects. Then there also is MP_diffuse, which just by using a slider lets you add a diffusion effect to your footage by scattering it into millions of tiny points. I've also created a new edge detection effect called MP_EdgeDetect2. It is really useful for getting very thin outlines and edges of an image. I've tested the edge detection on the image for the new thumbnails of MPComp, and since it includes a few different indicators for monitoring colors, I encountered a problem which made me rethink the edge detection we all know from other video editors. Usually edge detectors are based on the luminance, so the perceived brightness of an image. And this led to this rainbow indicator not being detected as expected, because the dark blue will be mapped to a lower level of luminance than the other colors, even though it technically is as bright as the other colors. So I've added a drop-down menu to the effect, which lets you apply the edge detection to either the luminance, the hue, the saturation, or the value of the image. And using these different methods, you can adjust the edge detection to work on pretty much every image there is. I never saw this possibility in other edge detectors, even though it seems like such an obvious feature. But let's move on to the next new effect, MP_spotlight. By using the effect, you can control a light cone that is used to relight its input. You can either set the light to always aim at a certain point, no matter where you position the light, or just get full manual control over its rotation angle. I've also implemented a sort of bump map to the effect, which helps retaining the visual depth of your footage. Of course, it's not a magic bullet that understands the full context of every image you feed into it, but on some examples, it worked really well. Alternatively, you can just use it to add some light shafts to your scene, especially since you can split the light into multiple streaks. These were the highlights of the new post-processing effects that have been added this update. But those only make up a fraction of the new content that has been added. So let's continue with the next new part of MPComp. This is a system that has been a work in progress for a long time. I created a set of adjustable 2D shapes inside Blenders Compositor, which you can use as masks or to create and animate visuals. The shapes are based on SDFs, and during the creation, my main objective has been making this rather complex system as user-friendly as I possibly can. So I've made sure that all the different shapes you can create feel consistent. For example, setting the ellipse to a scale of 0.5 will make it the same size as a rectangle with a scale of 0.5. I've also added the ability to round the corners of the box and triangle shape without drastically changing their scale, which usually is against the nature of SDFs. Also, you can adjust the position of all three points of the triangle, and I even added an UI overlay showing you which point corresponds to which setting. The UI overlay will also show the center and rotation on all the other shapes. Trust me, for the triangle, that has been a node-wrangling nightmare to turn it into something user-friendly. Once you've adjusted your shape, you can plug it into a MP_render_SDF node, where you can apply an outline, fill color, or even textures to your shape. The input shape will also receive an anti-aliasing effect to get rid of harsh pixelated edges. But let's get to the system I've built for those shapes. Currently, you can seamlessly create a morph animation between two shapes, cut them with each other, and also apply two different array effects to them. I've implemented both a grid array and a linear array, which allows you to create iterations of a shape or even any image you want, and then animate them with an adjustable offset between each iteration. These are the current possibilities of the system, but I plan to further expand it in the future. If you already enjoy what you currently get with the new SDF system of MPComp, I have something very interesting for you. Since I realized that not everyone is willing to spend money on something you can get for free, but still would like to support MPComp in another way, I contacted another add-on developer to collaborate. The developer in question is CG Flow, who is the creator of ProGraph and ProParticles, which both are very useful additions to Blender, especially if you like MPComp. Just like MPComp takes inspiration from After Effects and plugins like Sapphire, ProGraph and ProParticles take inspiration from the MoGraph system of Cinema 4D and XParticles. Since ProParticles is very complex and feature-rich, I want to take more time testing the product before showcasing it, so I will focus on ProGraph for this video. ProGraph is also an asset library that adds multiple node groups, which let you procedurally distribute objects and animate each instance using effectors. So we can control the animation for all instances with only adjusting a few values instead of dealing with hundreds of keyframes. There's definitely a learning curve to ProGraph, and you definitely need some existing experience for working with nodes, but once you get used to the different terms of ProGraph like cloner, field, and effector, you can just search for those terms using Shift A and create complex animations in no time. And apart from creating animations that already look good on their own, you can also combine it with MPComp, like gradually scaling a grid of planes and then using it as a mask inside the compositor to create a transition, or creating some shapes and animations to further process them in the compositor to simulate some sci-fi HUD elements. The pricing of CG Flow's products is very fair in my opinion, and when you buy their products over my referral link on SuperHive or Gumroad, I get a provision of what you pay without any additional costs for you. So you get a great set of tools for creating motion graphics and also support MPComp. This is the first time I'm doing an affiliate collaboration, and I'm glad that I ended up with a product that really is relevant for my audience. I hope you can appreciate this as well. But speaking of creating transitions, there's also another category of new effects inside MPComp, the transition category. Those have been designed to work flawlessly both in the traditional, real-time and VSE compositor. You just connect two image inputs to the node group and then keyframe the completion slider to go from 0 to 100%. I decided to rely on keyframes rather than an automatic animation, so you can easily create different easings for the transition. If you don't know how to switch between different easings and interpolations in Blender, you can check out my short tutorial on that. To use these transitions in the VSE, you just need two strips in your sequencer timeline and then add the compositor modifier to the strip that you want to transition to. And then expand the mask dropdown, make sure it's set to strip, and select the other clip for the transition. Now open up a compositor editor and set it to sequencer. As you can see, you have both an image and a mask input. The image input shows the strip the compositor modifier is applied on, and the mask input shows the other clip you define in the mask dropdown of the modifier. Now we can finally get to the exciting part of adding the transition. Just add any of MPComp's transitions to the compositor and connect the inputs accordingly. Since the mask input shows the prior clip in this case, you have to connect it to the start input of the node and the image input to the end input. When adjusting the completion slider, you should already see the transition happening. Then just add a keyframe for the completion being set to 0, move forward in the timeline, and add a keyframe for a completion of 100%. I recommend the distance between both keyframes to be somewhere between half a second and a full second. And then you're done. Now you can spend some time adjusting the settings of the node group or play around with different keyframe interpolations. This seems like a pretty long setup at first, but once you get used to it and already have the compositor editor opened, the process will become quicker. Due to the current lack of GPU support in the VSE compositor, I've kept the transitions rather basic. Once the Blender devs add GPU support to the compositor, you can expect an update with more complex transitions. Currently, the most complex one is the glare transition, which you can set up to use the different versatile glow effects of Blender's compositor. Blender 5.1 will also add a sequencer strip info node, which can output the start and end frame of a clip, which would allow me to add a well-working automatic mode to my transitions. About the other existing effects of MPComp, most effects generally work inside the sequencer compositor, but some of them, especially the ones relying on multiple procedural textures like MP underscore VHS, are painfully slow due to the lack of a GPU implementation. Some effects also seem to not work at all. I already reported some of the bugs and inconsistencies, so we will just have to wait until everything works flawlessly. Having the compositor work with the video sequencer is a huge milestone of Blender, and the developers are already working on adding GPU support. Since Blender 5.0 added the ability to add menus to compositor node groups, I was able to simplify a lot of existing nodes and also add some new features to them, like changing the sampling or switching between different blend modes for the film grain effect. Especially nodes like MP underscore pixel sort benefit from the update, since it used to rely on a lot of toggles, which have now been reduced to a single menu. Also, the displacement effects now use the new extension modes of Blender, instead of the custom in-paint setup I've made, which assures that displaced images don't get clipped. Another quality of life addition to Blenders Compositor is having an asset shelf at the bottom like you have for the different brushes in the sculpting tab. I personally like to set up the asset shelf to show different tabs for a better organization of the presets. Especially for MP Comp, this works really well as Blender will recognize the different categories of it. There's also a new convolve node in Blender which allows you to convolve an image using a kernel. The documentation already gives a few examples you can achieve using different kernels, but creating one inside the compositor is very tedious. So I've created a new utility node called MP underscore kernel creator, which creates a 3x3 matrix from customizable values and colors. You can just plug this into the kernel input of Blender's convolve or glare node and then customize the kernel. By default, MP underscore kernel creator is set to generate a kernel for edge detection. You can also further adjust the kernel by applying other compositor nodes to it, like using a Gaussian blur on it. I've also added another new category to MP Comp called 3D, which uses different render passes of Blender to realize different kinds of effects. The most useful of them is probably MP underscore bokeh blur 3D, which uses the depth pass to apply Blender's bokeh blur with depth-based falloff. It's especially cool because you can also use it to blur other compositing elements to add some depth to the initially 2D elements of your composition. Other effects of this category are Mist 3D, which lets you apply some atmospheric fog to your scene by using Blender's Mist Pass, MP underscore Snow 3D, which applies snow to surfaces in your scene by using the normal UV and ambient occlusion pass of Blender, and last but not least, there is MP underscore video game shading 3D, which simplifies the shading of your render by only using the ambient occlusion pass to add shading to the direct color or albedo pass of your render. This can help you recreating a retro 3D look, especially since I've also integrated a pixelation filter and oversaturated bloom effect to the node. One of the effect's limitations currently is not supporting reflective surfaces, but if you're going for that retro look, I would recommend baking the reflections into textures anyway. This category is also planned to be expanded in the future, but I think it already gives a few fun examples of how you can use the different passes of Blender. There are also some smaller new effects and changes in this update of MP Comp, so make sure to download it and check them out for yourself. I also appreciate everyone supporting this project, and I hope my collaboration with CG Flow opens up a new popular method of supporting MP Comp. So remember to use my referral link if you plan on purchasing their products. I also have a Discord server where you will always get notified about updates regarding MP Comp and new YouTube videos first. Alternatively, I also occasionally share work in progress updates on my Instagram. And that's all. I hope you will enjoy the new update. Have a wonderful day. Bye!